In this video, I explain comparisons between open cycle and closed cycle gas turbine power plants. So here on this first column, I mention this particular point, and with respect to that points, we do the comparisons of open cycle and closed cycle. Means on the second column, we mention the point of open cycle, and in this third column, we mention the point of closed cycle gas turbines. First particulars are operation of cycle. So in a open cycle gas turbine, the same working fluid is not recirculated again and again. So here in this diagram, we already explained in the open cycle. Here you see this compressor is take the fresh air from the atmosphere, and this gas turbine is reject the exhaust gas to the atmosphere. Means the working fluid are not recirculated again and again. The fresh charge is supplied to each cycle, and after the combustion and expansion, it is discharged to the atmosphere. Means compressor is continuously take the fresh air from the atmospheres, and gas turbine is reject the exhaust gas to the atmosphere continuously. Means the same working fluid is not recirculated. In a closed cycle gas turbine, the working fluid is recirculated again and again. So this is the diagram of the closed cycle gas turbine power plant. Okay, so here you see it is all the four component are closed, means the input of this compressor is connected with this cooler. So compared to this open cycle, in a closed cycle one component are added, and as a working fluid we are able to use air, heliums, neons or other gases like as the argons. Second comparison is on the basis of working fluid. So in open cycle gas turbine, air fluid mixers are used as a working fluid, and in a closed cycle gas turbine, the working fluid air or any other suitable gases as argon, helium and the mixture of helium and carbon dioxides can be used, which more favorable properties than air. Means these gases, argon, helium or neon, have a very good thermal properties compared to this air. That's why they are used in a closed cycle gas turbine power plants. Third point, that is a manner of heat transfer. Means how the heat transfer is carried out in a combustion chambers. So in open cycle gas turbine, fuel is directly mixed with air. Direct heat supply and heat is generated in the combustion chamber itself. Means the air coming from the compressors, they are mixed with the fuel. And in a combustion chambers, these air and fuel combustions are carried out, and due to this combustion, these exhaust gases are produced. Not exhaust gases, but some combustion gases are produced, and these gases is supplied to the turbine. In a closed cycle gas turbine, fuel is not mixed with the working medium. Okay. In open cycle, what happened? The fuel is mixed with the working medium, that is the air. Okay. So in a closed cycle, fuel is not mixed with the working medium, and heat produced by the fuel is transferred to the working fluid through a heat exchangers. So in a closed cycle, we already know that in the combustion chamber, working fluid is passed inside the tube, and the combustion of the fuel is carried out outside the tubes. Means it is called as the indirect heat transfer. Okay. In open cycle, that is a direct heat transfer are there. Fourth point, quality of heat input. So in open cycle gas turbine, it require a high grade heat energy. Means it required a superior quality of fuels. And in a closed cycle gas turbine, the heat can be supplied from the source like low grade fuels, waste heat, solar heat or a nuclear heat. But in open cycles, we need to use the good quality of the fuel, because if we use the bad quality of fuels, that is the chances of erosions and the corrosions of the turbine blades are increased. Now before moving ahead, I request to like the video and subscribe my channels for watching the more video related to the power plant engineering and other subject of this mechanical engineering. For power plant engineering, various link is provided in descriptions as well as in a car. For other subject, I request to visit the playlist. Next point is the type of fuel. So in open cycle gas turbine, it requires high quality oil or a gaseous fuel, because combustion is an internal part of a system. So we already know that in the combustion chambers, the fuel and air is mixed, then the combustion product is supplied to this turbine. Okay, that's why we require the high quality of the fuel. Means suppose we use the coal in open cycle gas turbine power plant. Okay, then what happened is fly ash produced by the combustion of the coal is supplied to the turbine, and this fly ash is creates a lots of problem inside this turbine. Okay, that's why these gaseous fuels or oil are used in a open cycle gas turbine. In a closed cycle gas turbine, any type of fuel can be used because heat is transferred externally. Means even we are able to use the coal in a closed cycle gas turbine because the working medium and the combustion product of a fuel are not mixed with each other. So we can use any type of the fuels for the closed cycle gas turbines. Next point is the efficiency. So in open cycle gas turbine, that it have the lower thermal efficiency for given temperature limits. Means we have the same temperature limits for the open cycle and for the closed cycles. Okay, so at that time this open cycle is give the low thermal efficiency and the closed cycle gas turbine give the higher thermal efficiency for a given temperature limits. Means both the cycles are work on the same temperatures, then we achieve the higher thermal efficiency in a closed cycle. Next point is the part load performance. So we already know what is the meaning of part load. Means the plant capacity is 100 megawatt and we run the gas turbine power plant for the 60, means plant capacity is 100 megawatt and we run the plant at 60 megawatt, 70, 80 or 90, it is called as the part load. Okay. So when we run the gas turbine power plant on the part load, then what happens? So in open cycle gas turbine, it have comparatively less thermal efficiency, and the closed cycle comparatively better thermal efficiency. Means even we run the closed cycle gas turbine on the part load, then it gives the better thermal efficiency compared to the open cycle. Point number 8 is the compactness. So size of the plant is large. Compactness means we are discussing the point in the form of the size. So open cycle gas turbine, it is a larger in size, and the closed cycle gas turbine plant is a size of the plant is less. Point number 9 is the control. So in a open cycle gas turbine, poor control on power production. Means power production control is poor, and in a closed cycle gas turbine, better control on power productions. Point number 10, life. So life of this open cycle gas turbine power plant is a less compared to the closed cycle gas turbines, because the combustion product directly passes through the turbine and hence the blade are subjected to higher thermal stresses and foiling. Therefore the life of the blade is shorter, means the life of the plant is also shorter. In a closed cycle gas turbine, due to indirect heat transfer in the combustion chambers, the combustion product do not come in a contact of a turbine blade. Thus there is a no blade foiling and a longer blade life. Point number 11, complexity. So this open cycle gas turbine plant, it do not require heater and cooler and hence the less complex. Okay, so in a closed cycle gas turbine power plant, it is the more complex compared to the open cycles because it have the heaters and coolers. Hence the plant is more complex. Last point is the cost. So cost of the open cycle gas turbine is less and the cost of the closed gas turbine is high. Not a larger, but it is a high. Okay, so by mistake here it is written as the large, but cost is high. So thank you for watching this video. If you learn something, then like the video,